We're unfortunately forced to wait another day, maybe two, to find out what's going to happen with the Stormy Daniels hush money, a possible indictment of Donald Trump. But more is coming out from sources around Donald Trump, including that he has told advisors that he wants to be handcuffed when he makes an appearance in court, if he is in fact indicted by a Manhattan grand jury for his role in the hush money payments. He has reasoned that since he would need to go to the courthouse and surrender himself to authorities for fingerprinting and a mugshot anyway, he might as well turn everything into a spectacle. Well, that's what he says. Not everyone around him believes this is a great strategy, and they don't necessarily trust why he says he wants this. People close to Trump say he's deeply anxious that any special arrangements like making his first court appearance by video or skulking into the courthouse would make him look weak or like a loser. And Trump's legal team has recoiled at the idea of him going in person and recommended that he allow himself to quietly turn himself in next week and schedule a remote video link appearance. But he's rejected that and told various allies over the weekend that he didn't care if someone shot him. He'd become a martyr. He later added that if he got shot, he would probably win the presidency in 2024. Maybe he's thinking of Bolsonaro getting stabbed or something like that. It's an interesting legal theory. We'll see if he gets to test it out. JR, what do you think?
Definitely sounds like a Donald Trump plan. It matches up completely with what he was promoting and saying was going to happen earlier this week. They're coming to arrest me. They're coming to come get me. Indictment. Look at these leaks. And the leaks are coming from inside the house. So it's the same thing. He's trying to promote himself. He is noticing maybe some other challengers coming aboard. And he's like, I need to make sure that I get this ahead of the time. I need to make sure that I weaponize normal legal proceedings against me now so that I can coalesce all these people before they fully decide to jump ship from me, which we've seen some have. So he also found a way to make sure that, you know, folks like Kevin McCarthy and other establishment Republicans then have come around and backed him up. Now he's got their voices on his side because they can't help themselves either because they're idiots. So he's done this whole tour. The one thing Donald Trump is good at, the only one thing Donald Trump is good at, is selling himself and selling whatever narrative he wants to sell. And he's selling this whole thing about how he's this victim. The unjust legal system is coming for him. Look at our two-tier justice system that somehow comes from the rich white guy who gets away with everything. That's the legal system that's coming for him. And don't you feel sorry for me. And Chris Sununu's dumbass went on TV and said the same thing. This is only going to generate some sympathy for him. So do you really think if Joe Biden got arrested, if Hunter Biden got pulled in the way they want him to be, do you think a bunch of Republicans would start to feel sorry for him? It doesn't make any sense.
Well,
it works out for them.
That's a great point, JR. But I think there's two potential ways to deal with it. So either like that points out that they don't really mean it and they don't actually want him to be arrested, because otherwise, why wouldn't it work the same way with Joe Biden? Or it's them revealing that when it comes to Joe Biden, people would reasonably be like, oh dear God, he committed crimes. But Trump's cult is so immune to reason and rationality that reality gets turned on its head. So I don't know. It doesn't look good for them in either case, though. But anyway, we'll see. Look, I think that it's entirely possible that it could actually help him in the primary. I don't simply believe that there's a lot of independent Americans that are desperate to have a jailbird as president or whatever for, you know, these many crimes. But maybe I'll be wrong. I've been wrong in the past. For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.